distributed into two half. So centriole helps in cellular division, that is microtubule organizing regions, we can call it as. Then we have discussed about then we will discuss the lysosomes. So lysosomes, they carry some enzymes in it, lysosomal proteins, which helps in the hydrolysis of some molecules. Mitochondria, where it contains or where the process of citric acid cycle, TCA cycle takes place. It is regarded as the powerhouse of a cell, where the energy is synthesized and stored, or it has been converted into what we can say, the terminal electron acceptor oxygen, ETC takes place over their electron transport chain. So TCA and electron transport chain, both of them, they takes place in mitochondria. Therefore it is regarded as the powerhouse of a cell. So it is present in animal cells, also seen in plant cells. In case with animal cells, it also has an organelle called as a lysosome, which contains some enzymes required for the hydrolysis of molecules. So all these organelles are present in an animal cell. So this is what we have discussed till now. Nucleus, this is the nuclear membrane, outer membrane, inner membrane, these small openings, they are the nuclear pores. Nucleolus is this region where we can find the DNA present inside a cell, and through this nuclear pores the molecule can move across the nucleus. The outer membrane, this is outer membrane, this is inner membrane. So this is the electron micrograph image of the nucleus. Nucleus, as we have discussed, it is the central or important organelle of a cell, can be regarded as the brain of a cell, as it carries the genetic material of a cell. It controls the activities of the cell. Largest organelle of a cell, having 10 to 20 micrometer in diameter. Then one nucleus per eukaryotic cell. Again, most of the cells has only one nucleus. Sometimes we can also find more than one nucleus. Such conditions are rarely seen, not seen in normal cells. Contains most genetic information, that is the DNA, visible only at the onset of cell division, that is during the M phase of cell cycle. Visible next, otherwise disappeared, and it looks or it shows the structure, that is chromatin, or we can call that as a chromosome. So chromatin fibers, when they are further condensed, they form the chromosomal structures. They are surrounded by the double membrane structure, nuclear membrane, that is nuclear envelope. We have discussed this. Inner membrane encloses nucleoplasm. The fluid, liquid fluid present inside a nucleus is nucleoplasm. Nuclear pore, they are around 100 nanometer in diameter. Numerous nuclear pores can be seen on the surface of nucleus. Helps in the movement of molecules like RNA and protein across the nuclear pore. Nucleolus, one or more, can be seen in inside a nucleus. They are the synthesis of rRNA. So we know this rRNA, they are present in ribosome, but they are synthesized in within a nucleus. So nucleolus, it is the site within a nucleus where we find rRNA. So this is the wrapping of DNA. So in prokaryotic cell, we have discussed the structure of DNA. It is double-stranded circular DNA. While in case with the eukaryotic cell, this is further compacted, it is condensed, and this DNA, it interacts with basic proteins and forms the nucleosome model. Then further it forms solenoid model, and it keeps on condensing and form the structure, the final structure, we call it as a chromosome. So this DNA, it is in association with proteins, it forms the chromosomal structures, which is present within a nucleus. This is not seen in case with the prokaryotic cell. Here is a comparison between prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells. Prokaryotic cell contains a single circular genome or chromosome, while eukaryotic cell it has multiple or several chromosomes. That is, the genome is divided into separate several chromosomes. While prokaryotic chromosomes are condensed in the nucleoid via DNA supercoiling and binding of various architectural proteins. So though the prokaryotic cell do not have histone proteins, but histone like proteins are there, which helps in supercoiling of that DNA. While in case with eukaryotic cell, the eukaryotic chromosomes are condensed in a membrane bound nucleus via histones. Because prokaryotic DNA can interact with the cytoplasm, transcription and translation occurs simultaneously. That is what we call it as a co-transcriptional translation. Because there is no such compartment, the process of transcription can be coupled with the translation. In case with eukaryotic cell, as the process of transcription takes place within a nucleus, this mRNA has to be processed and it has to come outside the nucleus for the process of translation. So no coupled transcriptional translation can be seen in case with eukaryotic cell. Most prokaryotic cell contains only one copy of each genome, that is haploid genome. In case with eukaryotic cell, some eukaryotic genome are organized into operon, but most are not. Most eukaryotic contains two copies of each gene, that is the DNA is diploid. So we have 23 pairs of chromosomes. So we have 23 chromosomes only, but we have 23 pairs of chromosomes. So altogether we have alternate forms of gene that we know, that alleles, that is the two copies of same content can be seen. One might be coming from maternal side and other from paternal side in case with the zygotic cell, zygotic diploid cell. But in case with prokaryotic cell, the genome is mostly haploid in nature. Non-essential prokaryotic genes are commonly encoded on extra chromosomal plasmids. So if you remember, we have discussed the prokaryotic cell E. coli cell, which contains 4×10^6 base pair genome and it codes for around 4000 genes. That is most part of the genome, it codes for the functional product. While in case with the eukaryotic cell, we will discuss this, that the major part of the chromosome is not coding for the functional product directly. Only around 1.5 to 1.8% of the genome, it codes for the genes, directly codes for the genes. Rest of them is, some of the part is repetitive DNA, some of it is non-repetitive, unique and other elements. But in prokaryotic cell, such thing is rarely seen. Extrachromosomal plasmids are not commonly present in eukaryotic cell that we have seen in case with the prokaryotic cells. Prokaryotic genomes are efficient and compact, containing little repetitive DNA, while the eukaryotic cell, it contains large amount of non-coding and repetitive DNA. So this, the DNA contained, the genome size may be onto a larger side, but the number of genes are not directly proportional to the size of the genome. I think we should stop here.